All right, guys. I've solved the Immortal Sorceress. I'm putting this video out first. This is the kind of where I ended up with it. And subsequently, I think I will release the journey through it. It's kind of like a playthrough. You'll see a series of videos come out that will showcase where I was with it and how I got to here, basically. And I'll put that in a playlist so you can watch it in order. And this will be like the cap end to it, okay? So for anyone interested in that. So let me just demonstrate first. We're in Terrorized Durance of Hate. Okay. You'll notice we have almost 3,000 mana. Yeah. Okay. Just watch. We can go over the gear and everything after. I just want to show some gameplay. Let's find some dolls. You will also notice there is no insight and no prayer running right now.
I need a key.
So no meditation aura, no prayer. Okay. We gotta find these dolls here. Where are they at, man? I gotta find. Here we go. Here we go. Wow. Look at that. Did you guys see that? We just stood in the middle of a bunch of exploding dolls in a Terrorized Durance of Hate. I think, and our mercenary is powerful, okay? He is not limited by prayer and insight right now for his damage output. Watch this. You like that? Yeah, that's pretty amazing, isn't it? So yeah, I've solved this build. And I'm very happy with it now. I think this build is super fun now, whereas before I didn't like it. Yeah, look at that. I'll use one potion, okay? Just because we're poison. Yeah, I'm gonna keep going here, keep playing, and then we can go over all the gear and everything after, because I just think that showing it right now explains it pretty well. You know, is that, hey, it's working. We're not having to keep an eye on our life pool too much, or our mercenary. He's surviving wonderfully. Yeah, I think that's great. So here we go. Let me redo this. Okay. We're gonna keep going with the gameplay first, and then we'll turn to level 3. Alright, so here's a good test, right? Mm-hmm. Wow, look at that. Could you even see what was happening there? We're getting so heavily attacked. Take that potion. Let me just redo these just in quick case. I know I just did them not that long ago, but it'd be nice to have a little timer on the like bottom somewhere, like in the corner, that just kind of showed you what things were running out, you know? All right, let's get these guys. And we leveled up. Look at that. We're now level 84. Yeah. Okay. So, like I said, there'll be other videos coming out that kind of show where we were at with this before. And how we ended up here. And they'll be in a playlist that you can watch as like a playthrough. I've decided that's how I want to do it. I think that'll be the most interesting way to kind of see it if you're interested in that, you know, to see how I got here. It definitely took some testing, some playing with the build. I had to like figure out how to play the build, actually. Yeah, I mean, this is by far the best iteration of this Immortal Sorceress I've ever seen. And it took me several hours of playing and figuring out how best to use it. Whoops, I did not mean to do that. Here we go. Rebuff. There we go. All right, let's go for Terrorized Mephisto. Let's see, is he going to be a problem for us? No, he's not. And you know, if you know me, you know I got to check some of these blue armors, right? Okay, mace, gauntlets. I'd like to pick up all of those things.
It's locked.
It's locked. Okay. Great. Thul rune. Okay. So first thing, let me just run back to town really quick. Identify. Grab that thing, because you never know. Right? No. All res 13? No. 1 to javelin, 10% increased attack speed? No. Let me grab that and that for fun, you know. And Deckard, if you'd Hello. Be so kind as to identify for us, thank you. And no. Alright. So. You saw it, right? You saw. We stood in the middle of all the dolls. We did Terrorized Mephisto. The Council. You know, all those guys in the bottom who shoot hydras everywhere, and nobody died. Nobody even got hurt. Yeah. This build is really cool now. I didn't like it before. So here we go. Let's look at the gear. First of all, you saw we had almost 3,000 mana once our battle orders was up, right? Let me go with the charms first this time. Life and mana charm. Mana charm with gold. I actually like the extra gold. You'll notice our gold is 299% extra gold from monsters without a Geeds. Kind of cool, right? 8 mana, 10% gold. I got strength mana, 10% gold. Strength mana, a 17-19 Annie. 16 mana with 3% magic find. 17 mana, 17 mana. Those are perfect rolls on those. The large charms, the grand charms, I mean. Dexterity mana, 57 mana, 53 mana, 56 mana, 58 mana, 18 life, 58 mana, 35 to life, 49 mana, 58 mana, and 16 life, 53 mana. Okay? So we have tons of mana, and we are boosting that regeneration and pool by having things like Mage Fist. One to fire skills, 25% regenerate mana. We have this Gloom's Trap mesh belt. You might have noticed I picked that up with my Nova Sorceress the other day. This has 15% increased maximum mana with 15 vitality and regenerate mana 15%. Okay. We also have Natalia's Shadow. I love this for this build because, well, it's got three sockets, so I could put in three perfect skulls in it to get 15 replenished life, 57% regenerate mana. But also, it comes with some poison res, and the poison length reduced by 75%, which is huge for energy sorceress, okay? We also get the life to mana, or the life based on character level, which is kind of nice. Okay, and it's got this cool black kind of color to it. See that? Which is, it just looks kind of cool on the character. Boots are just rare boots. More gold finds, 69%. Cold resist 40 and lightning resist 39. Awesome rolls on those. We get a little run walk with those as well. The Nova when struck is just a cool effect that happens since we're getting struck a lot. Okay, the amulet, look at this. 56 to mana, damage reduced by 24. Perfect for this build, right? Our damage reduction, as you'll see, is 70. Damage reduced by 70 and magic damage reduced by 48. Look at the shield. Gurki's Sanctuary. Replenish life plus 22, because I put a Dole Rune in it, which gives 7 more replenished life. All resistances plus 27. Damage reduced by 12 and magic damage reduced by 8. This rolls the res, the damage reduced, and the magic damage reduced have varying rolls. So I liked this one the best. I found a couple of those. Wizard Spike. The cast rate is wonderful. The increased maximum mana 15% and the regenerate mana 15%. All resistances 75, mana based and character level. Perfect for this build. The Helmet. Angel's Tiara of Life Everlasting. 1 to sorceress skill levels, damage reduced by 34 because I put in 2 soul runes and it came with damage reduction. The rings are dwarf stars, 2 of them, they both rolled perfect. Magic damage reduced by 15 on each of them. We get our fire absorb there. If you'll notice, our fire resistance is only 51%, which is actually perfectly fine to have this much fire absorb. 30% fire absorb with 51% fire res, we're perfectly good. Okay. You'll notice the other ones are all capped out at 75. So, we have, overall, tons of gold find, which helps us with repairs and, you know, charges for our demon limb that we use in our mercenary. We have replenished life 37. We're at a 70% faster cast. We do have the poison length reduced by 75%, which is great. We have damage reduced by 70, magic damage reduced by 48. And our regenerate mana, okay? It says 370%, but that for some reason that doesn't calculate properly. But basically we have 15 on the Wizard Spike, 25 on the Mage Fist, 15 on the Gloom Trap, 57 on my Natalia's Shadow, and then I have, in the skills, 294% on the Warmth. All right? Which that'll go up 1 skill when you use battle orders. Battle command, I mean. So 20 into warmth. I'm leveling fire mastery. I've got 17 there. 20 into firewall. Because we stand still and just tank. So I just kind of like using this with that. And it synergizes with warmth. And we get benefit from fire mastery. The other thing that synergizes with warmth is enchant. So what we do is we take the demon limb. And we use enchant on our Emilio, who is now Zanari. Because I wanted Might Mercenary. The thing that we cracked here, okay, is that we don't need insight in prayer on the mercenary for this immortal sorceress to work. That is the thing that makes my version of this so great. That I love a lot, okay? So let's move this over here again. Let's go over the mercenary. Here's our Emilio, or Zanari, Might Mercenary, instead of prayer. He's got Eth Treachery for the fade and the attack speed and the venom. He's got a G-Face with 15% increased attack speed, and he's got a Reaper's Toll with a Shale Rune in it. He hits fast, and he hits pretty hard with the Decrep and the Might. And look at, he's got 48% Deadly Strike, 35% chance of Crushing Blow, Ignore Target's Defense, 50% faster hit recovery, 80% increased attack speed. He gets more gold as well. So our gold find is actually 349% when he's killing things. So that's awesome. We always have like hundreds of thousands of gold by the end of the runs. Okay. So that is my immortal sorceress. Her name is appropriately A Mortal, which is cool. We leveled up actually, so let's see. Do we need the strength? No, we don't. Cool. You know what? I'm gonna put in more into should I do more mana? It seems kinda crazy, right? To do more and more mana. But why not? Just see where it goes. Okay. And then the skill. I can do another one in Fire Mastery. There we go. And now let's go back. Let's just go to another area here. And let's buff and see where we're at now.
I'll put that to good use.
Okay. So now... sorry, one second. Alright, so now it says we are sitting at 2,877 mana. Let's see, these guys drain mana. How bad is it? Did we even lose anything? Not really. Town portal, sure. So, you'll notice we're frozen because we do not have cannot be frozen, but our res is max, so it doesn't wear on us too long. Okay. Great, champions. Nice, he leveled up. He's getting hurt a little bit. Maybe his fade hadn't engaged yet. Okay. Yeah, look at that. So I'm just like casting Firewall and then Tele Stomping. Sometimes I'll Tele Stomp and then cast Firewall. it kind of just doesn't matter really. But yeah, look at that. Anyway, I mean, this is it, man. I don't really know. I guess, like, you could improve it a little bit more damage-wise by doing, like... Oh, look at this. An F Soul Harvest. That'd be good for leveling, wouldn't it? On an Act 2 Mercenary? What's this great bow? What was I saying? Oh my gosh, I just lost my train of thought. I'm so sorry. I was saying... What was I saying? Oh boy, that's embarrassing, right? Okay, so basically what I was trying to... I think what I was trying to get at is that, I've solved this build. Oh! The mercenary, right? Sorry. You could go with a different mercenary now. You know, you could do a grief on an Act 5 mercenary of some kind, and just give him that with like anything, and just watch yourself wreck. I will say that the decrep though, from the Reaper's Toll, gives you even better safety. So anyway, this is it, man. The Immortal Sorceress. I've solved it for myself. I don't think I've seen anyone run exactly this type of setup for it. You know? You also notice no torch. We don't even have a torch. But yeah, I really like it like this. I think this has great survivability. And I know I'm just repeating myself, but we have no prayer, no insight running on the mercenary. And we have incredible sustain. Because of our 37 replenish life, very high damage reduction, and when we use our battle orders, we are at almost 3,000 mana. Look at that. Crazy high. You know? Okay, guys. That is the Immortal Sorceress, and it's one of its best forms that I think I could make it. Remember, we're online. No hero editing. So, I made this online. Thank you so much for checking out the videos. Go back and watch the journey of how I got here. It was slow moving at first, so just be aware of that. Thank you. See you later.